all who are attending the course here. It's a very great opportunity to deliver a lecture on a recent topic where the world is going on, like renewable energy. So everyone is looking after the alternative sources of energy.
Hello, Patel sir.
Yeah.
Please switch on your camera.
Camera is on actually.
Yeah, yes, sir.
Now you got it?
Yeah. Doing presentation. So,
yeah, presentation is. Is it view to everyone? Presentation is view to everyone?
So make it presentation mode.
Okay.
No. Make it presentation. Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
So very warm good morning, and it's a very great to have this topic as they have chosen for an faculty development program, because all the research oriented work is now going on to the renewable energy sources. Everyone is looking after these sources of energy, so that fossil fuel we can pave it for the future generations and for the many of the. So this topic, I'm not wasting any time related to this. I know that all of you are very much aware of the wind energy, but how it works, what are the applications, where India stands on the wind energy, we'll look after in this this lecture. So first of all, I will introduce basics, that how wind energy is generated and from where it comes. So our agenda of this, that origin of wind. The wind energy is generated from the wind. So we are taking the power of the nature or the natural power as a resource for creating the energy. And the second introduction is introduction to wind energy, the history of wind energy, how the wind energy originated and how it comes up to the 2020. Introduction to the wind turbine, types of the wind turbines and its working, wind turbine design, wind energy status in India, future trends of wind energy. This is our agenda of today's lecture. So first, wind. All of you have heard that wind, Hindi mein hum usko kahenge hawa, aise keh dete hain log. So wind is generally a movement of air, It can be of a three types. First is the wind. Wind means the horizontal movement of the air. So the movement of the air which is horizontally works, it is the wind. And the second one is the air current. Air current means which is the vertical movement of the air. And third one is when it together comprises of horizontal and vertical, it comes the circulation. So there are the three types of categories of the air movement, that is wind, air current and circulation. Our basic idea was to take the energy from this wind, because air current and circulation are above our height and we cannot collect the energy from that area, because it cannot occur all the time, but wind can occur mainly all the time. So the next part is types of wind. What are the various types of winds we are having? We are having the planetary wind. This is the first type. Second one is the periodic wind, and third is the local wind. The first planetary wind, what is the planetary wind? There are three main planetary winds. Planetary winds means across our globe or across our Earth planet, which always flow permanently, like polar islets, polar regions. It flows like a trade wind, polar wind, and westerly wind, which always flow in the same direction and always throughout the year and throughout the one rotation of the Earth. These winds never change. This always flows in the same direction, same thing. So there are the three types of planetary wind. One is the trade wind, second one is the westerly wind, third one is the polar wind. Now, the second part of the wing is the periodic wind. Like you have seen the, heard the seasons are there, monsoon season, summer season, winter season. Like that, this is the periodic wind, which occur in a period of certain time. For example, land and sea breeze. Means morning hours, it comes to the rising of the air. Sea breeze comes towards the seashore. In the second night, due to the attraction of the moon, it comes back to the sea, and you have heard that water level is going down. So this, here the wind blows, this is a periodic system. Like that monsoon, this is the periodic system. It never comes in the summer, it never comes in the winter. It comes only in the monsoon season. Like that mountain and valley breezes, this also comes to the periodic, like day wise and night wise. So these are the periodic winds, which occurs periodically. Then third part is your local wind. The many are confused about the local wind. What is the local wind? Local wind depends upon the area where it blows. Like in an urban city, some wind naturally blows due to the temperature difference or due to the wind friction. It occurs in the urban areas. Like in village areas, you see that many times the air blows very easily. In the cities, it never blows due to the higher high-rise building. It have a blockage of the flow of the wind. So local wind means it blows according to the area, according to the month. It can also, like as a loo, in the summer seasons, you always feel the loo. In desert areas, you always feel a loo type of hot air blowing. So these are the local winds. So local winds are of hot wind and cold wind. Hot wind is Chinook, Fawn, Santa. Cold winds are the Mistral and Northern. So these are the type of local winds which blows locally. Now how the wind is created? We have heard that we are having the types of winds. What are the factors which create this wind? We are having the three factors which create this wind. First, all of you know that pressure difference always create the some pressure gradient always create the change in pressure. Change in pressure always affect the force. So pressure gradient force, the change in pressure measured across the distance is called pressure gradient. These pressure gradients result in the net force that directly from high pressure to the low pressure. So this pressure gradient force creates the unevenness of the air flowing. So this unevenness creates the wind. Or it creates the change in the already existing wind, which are called as the permanent wind, like planetary wind, which are created by the nature. It changes its speed or changes its direction to pressure gradient force. The second one is the Coriolis effect. Coriolis effect, see, it's a very major effect that we are movement of bodies in the Earth's surface. It's not similar to the movement of the direction of the Earth. So this against movement of the individuals, airplanes, missiles, or path of any object in the Earth's surface, according to the rotation of the Earth, it creates some differences in the pressure zone. So this effect creates the wind speed or creates the wind direction. And third one is the friction. Friction means urban areas, nowadays large buildings, high rises buildings are there. This creates the flow of the wind. So it creates more and more another type of circulation, air movement, etc. So these all the factors which create the wind or change the speed of the permanent wind. This is the wind pattern in India. We are having a wind pattern in India. In summer, we are having the inward wind. In winter, we are having the downward wind from the Bay of Bengal or from the Arabian Sea. Now, what is the wind? Now, this compares that now you understand what is the wind, types of wind, and what are the, how wind is created or how it is altered. So now wind energy is produced. How we can take the energy of the nature which they have given free of cost to us to energy which we use so that we can have the human comfort, because all we are doing for the comfort of the human being, if we can live in the jungle. So we did not need any energy or did not need any electricity. So we want to run our ACs, we want to run our industry, we want the electricity, which has been a great development to the human being. So for running this electricity, we want the electricity, and how the electricity will be generated, or how this natural energy we can use it for our comfort. So wind energy is produced by the movement of air, and it is converted into power for human use. So wind has been a source of energy for more than 1,000 years, but was replaced by fossil fuels for much of the 20th century. In ancient also, we are using wind. I will show you in the later set how the wind energy has been used in the ancient time. But now it again come back as a non-renewable energy sources because we are lacking of the fossil fuel. We are not getting fossil fuel too much in every area. So we are worried that how this fossil fuel can be stored for the future generation. It might be that after 50 years or 100 years, it can be exist. So we are in a worry that how we can save these fuels for the future generation. So we are now going for an alternative sources. So the wind energy is the major source which the world is going on, and they are making more and more viable and more efficient to develop these sources of renewable energy. The first windmill was the production of electricity was built in the Scotland in July 1887 by Professor James Smith of Anderson College. So this was the first windmill which was built. Now, the wind energy conversion system. From the wind energy, we are having two types of conversion systems. One is windmill, which converts wind energy directly into mechanical energy. In the ancient times, what I have told that in the ancient times, we are using this windmill, not for getting the electricity, but milling the grain, pumping the water, which we have already using it from our ancient time. But nowadays we have converted these mechanisms into a wind turbine mechanism. Wind turbine mechanism which convert the wind energy directly into the electrical energy. After the development of the turbine, we have got the windmills converted into the wind turbine. So wind turbines will create the wind energy into directly to the electrical electricity. Basic terminology is that it creates into the mechanical energy. The mechanical energy is directly is related to the electrical energy by the mechanism which gives a rotor, a hub assembly or a coil through which we can get the electricity. So both are interrelated, but these are the ancient works where you use only for the milling and pumping water, but nowadays we are getting it as a source of energy or source of electrical energy directly from the wind turbine. Now, history of wind. This gives a very great that 4000 in early 4000 BC, ancient Chinese was the first to attach sails to their primitive rafts. They get the force of the wind and sailed their boats with a huge cargo of 260 tons or to 700 people. So it's not that this wind, they are using the wind energy in a recent time or a recent 200 years development. It was the development from last so many years. The ancient characters, this is the ancient characters, which means, which now the Chinese language, it is similar to sail in ancient Chinese. It means the sail. So they have used this ancient characters also defined from that use. So sailing was one of the applications for the wind energy they have brought into the before the 2020 or 2000 AD. Now the second of the wind energy was the windmill. Windmills, all the results, all the history tells that China and European countries have developed the windmill before in 1180s or 1800 sections. So the basic reality is that before 1800 years, this windmill has been designed, and they are using this windmill for different purpose. And the windmills, what they have designed, are known as smoke mill, Dutch mill, and the fan mill. So this windmill used for grain, selling the grain or taking pumping out of the water. They have never thought of the creating the electricity from that. So the future before the windmills are, this is your Dutch mill, this is your smoke mill, and this is the fan mill. So these are the ancient windmills which already exist, which our ancient has been developed. So these mills are already in the place. They are collecting the mechanical energy from the wind in the future. Means our ancient people has already thought of it, that this is the power, this is the nature's power which they have given to us, so that we can get this energy and apply to for the human comfort. And the third part is your wind turbine. Now, how the wind turbines work? From windmill to wind turbine, we have a great lot of research gone from past ancient. The first wind turbine was operated, fully automatically operated wind turbine was designed and built by Charles Russ in 1888. Then the wind turbine was equipped with 144 SEDAR. This is the SEDAR, which are telling the 144 SEDAR blade having a rotational diameter of 17 meter. It generated a peak power of 12 kilowatt to charge batteries that supply DC currents to lamp and electric motor. So this is the first development of wind turbine, which comes into existence in 1888 by Charles Brush. Then it again got its first three-bladed steel wind farm or steel wind turbine in 1950s. See that how it takes a journey from 88 to 50. In 62 years, after 62 years development of this wind turbine to three-bladed rotor assembly. So it takes 62 years for this development. So today in modern wind turbine, they're three-blade operating at relative high. This comes from the Gatzer wind turbine. This is a Gatzer wind turbine, which is having a three-bladed option. So we looked at our people has done a lot of work for taking this energy as our day-to-day life. And we have collected the power from natural given energy and as our source of daily use for our comfort. So a lot of people has worked on this. So Gatzer has designed this wind turbine and make into the operational. This is the operational, which comes in the 1950s. And one more theory was there, that Heroes engine was there. Heroes wind power organ was also there. You heard about the Heroes engine. Then Heroes has also developed a musical instrument operated from a wind. So this was also a great achievement at ancient times of taking the wind energy. So we are nowadays, we can see that this is the wind turbine in 1950 and these are the wind turbine at 2020. So lot of research has been done in last 50, 60 years, 70 years. So this 70 years has done with a lot of research, and due to this research, we are getting that we are having a two types of wind turbine. Types of wind turbine means, wind turbines are there, it gives the electricity, it generates the electricity, not gives the electricity, it generates the electricity. So how we can define it? All the wind turbines will generate the electricity, but they have given types according to their shape and size or configuration. There are the two types of wind turbine there. Horizontal axis wind turbine means the axis of the blade of the hub assembly of the rotor will be horizontally situated. And here the axis of the will be vertically located. So there are two types of wind turbine. One is the horizontal axis wind turbine and the second one is the vertical axis wind turbine. So horizontal axis wind turbine, a wind turbine which axis of the rotor rotation is parallel to the wind stream. It is parallel to the wind stream. All the grid connected commercially wind turbines today are built with a propeller type rotor and a horizontal. These are known as the propeller type rotor. This is a propeller and this is a rotor. Horizontal axis wind turbine have three main rotors, shaft, an electrical generator at the top. Electrical generator, in the next slide I will show you that what is the schematic diagram for this electrical generator, and may be pointed into or out of the wind. Small turbines are pointed by a simple wind vane, which large turbines generally use wind sensor coupled with a servo motor. Horizontal axis wind turbines has also a subdivision, like a downward wind turbine and a upward wind turbine. Now the second one is the vertical axis wind turbine. Vertical axis wind turbine will be the having the axis of rotation vertically, and the main rotor shaft is set vertically, and the main components are located at the base of the turbine. See, both are having a difference. Here all the components like a generator and everything is in the base of the turbine. There all the at the topmost position of the turbine. Vertical axis wind turbine falls into two major categories: Doris type like lift device and Torus type like drag device. One is create the energy from the drag. One is creating the energy from the lift. See, vertical axis wind turbine are only a research oriented work. It never gives the full efficiency. It gives the efficiency better than the horizontal, but lot of problems arises in this. So due to that problems, currently it is only for the research and for the development that these type of turbines are used. Commercially, only the horizontal wind turbines are used nowadays. Here is a comparison of the both of the wind turbine. Horizontal axis wind turbine are complexity in accessible drivetrain increase the OM cost, like overall and maintenance cost is increase in these horizontal axis wind turbine, because we have to climb up and all the repairs and has to be done at the upper side, so the maintenance cost will be increased. Here the all the this is situated at downward, so all the operational cost will be decreased because here the maintenance will be easy. Blade pitch system, here the pitching system has to be done because all the way here the rotation of the motor has to be done because the wind direction changes. Like wind 15 days of wind direction in the one day, suppose it can change to the another direction, so we have to rotate this hub assembly. So there is a provision of the latest wind turbines which developed, which can rotate its hub, or we can rotate the pitch also for getting the maximum efficiency. Pitch means the changing the angle of the blade. Changing the angle of the blade, we can change the pitch of that. But here it is no need to do that because this is a fixed type of structure where if wind comes from any of the direction, it will go. Now, what is the wind turbine mechanism? I will explain. This is the basic schematic of a wind turbine. This is a tower where inside the tower we have all this instrument or panel boxes which creates the electricity, which gives the automatic pitching or microprocessor which controls the turbine mechanism. This is the structure of the tower, because for the maintenance cost we have to go upstairs. We want to take all this thing has been covered with an material. Mainly we are using a composite material for the wind turbine blades, because we know that we want the big structure, but the structure should be light in weight. See, here also it is well with the gray gear train which can rotate the whole assembly towards the change. This is the motor generator, which is directly coupled with the hub of the wind turbine. This is the wind direction mechanism, which can give the direction of the wind. Here the coupling force is there, gear train will be there, the motor will be there. This is a live picture of the gear train motor of the wind turbine. Nowadays, large wind turbine like 120 meter blades are there. So all the units of generating electricity or the battery units are also nowadays situated in the tower itself. Before that, the battery units are situated at the outside. Now you understand that why battery units are needed. So many times, because we are collecting the wind energy throughout the day or night. So many times we not need in the grid of the electric energy. So that energy is to be stored into the battery systems. That I will later on, I will explain the how the energy has been distributed across the grid through the wind turbine, how it is distributed. So already we thought that the horizontal axis wind turbine, all the major running instrument has been located at the top of the tower. That's why we are told that maintenance cost is more in this type of wind turbine considered as compared to the vertical axis wind turbine. These wind turbines always have the greater maintenance cost, but it gives the great efficiency . Now that was the schematic diagram for the or a mechanism for the wind turbine, horizontal axis wind turbine. Likewise, vertical axis wind turbine has the blade length, a generator at the downward side, a tower here, a shaft will be there, the blades are there, which will be located from this connected to this shaft through a truss type of structure, so that it will rotate throughout the here. But in this case, the problem arises was, if a wind comes from this side, it not gives the fully access to all the other blades. All the other blades will be not given the full access to that wind. So that will be a problem, because these blades are of aerofoil shape. So aerofoil shape, this aerofoil will situated at different angle of attack. So these aerofoil shapes give a different angle of attack. So here the problem arises that how the wind can cope up with all the blades. All the blades cannot work at the same efficiency. But in vertical axis, all these blades give a greater efficiency, and everyone will have their own working phenomena so that it will rotate. But here the problem was, another problem is that this is in the contact with the wind, so it cannot give every blade a same angle of attack or same force created by the blade. Now we already seen that the wind energy is there, a gearbox is there, a generator is there, which gives the power to the power converter. Converter which gives the power to the transformer, or a system protected device is then and is directly supplied to the grid. Here all the microprocessor and pitch arrangement softwares are installed, so that we not need that every person has to handle one wind turbine every day or we have to set the pitch or set this, like an airplane is there, in an aircraft also there is a pitching, flaps are there which is operated by the pilot. But here everything has been already set up, that this direction of the wind will be there, then pitch should be this, all the analysis and software has been developed and installed, so they can mode in an automatic mode. If a wind direction is this, they will automatically turn or they will automatically set their pitching angle of the blade. Here the battery storage system is there if we not need from this grid any power, so we can have the system of the storage also. Now we can see a small presentation for the power distribution, how this power distribution works. You can get the electricity as a yellow line. It gives the electricity direct to the grid line from here. Now these grid lines work, but now with that there is no energy. So we have, what we have to do, we have to get the energy from thermal power section. We have to get the energy from thermal power station. This is the problem which arises if the wind is not there at that time. So we have to run the thermal power systems. But if the wind is more or we did not need that energy, so there is a need of the storage devices which is already connected, like as a battery storage power station. So these storage devices now what will do, they will store the energy which is not needed at the time of the grid or not supplied to the grid. So these storage devices has a fast response batteries or a slow response batteries. Fast response batteries have a 1 megawatt oblique of 39 megawatt hours for 20 minutes and the slow response batteries of 0.7 megawatt for a 1 hour. So if we need a slow voltage system, so we will get from the slow response batteries. And if it's a high voltage system or large generation, so it gives from the high voltage batteries. So now the continuous power supplies from the wind can be done. So this type of system has been developed in the wind farm. It is not actually the wind individual wind turbine has a wind has the battery station. These are the wind farms, means 10 to 20 or 30 wind turbines collectively has a one base station. These base stations will connect it to the grid. These energy which is created from the base station, either it will connect it to the grid or either it will go to the battery station. So this type of power distribution systems which are existing in the wind turbines, wind energy farms. Now already I told that comparison of the horizontal axis wind turbine and vertical axis wind turbine. The power generation efficiency is 50 to 60%. It's above 70%. But there are lot of problems, like steering mechanism wind is, yes, we have a steering mechanism of the wind. Here it is not, we are not having any steering mechanism of the wind. If a wind blows in the single direction, it gives the 70%, but it's not having the steering mechanism. So if it blows in the different directions in a short period of time, then it should be lower than this. Overall efficiency will be low. Blade rotation speed will be quite large, it's very small. Wind resistance capacity will be weak. It will be strong as it resists the wind because its hub is in the ground station, its hub is in the up station. Noise will be here, the noise will be very much, here the noise will be low because it cannot affect, it flows throughout it. Starting wind speed will be high, it will be low. Failure rate will be high, will be low. Maintenance will be complicated, it will be convenient. As everyone sees that these parameters are good, but why we are not using it? Because of this, it's the steering mechanism of the wind. We cannot operate it at any of the directions of the wind. That's why. Effect of the birds will be great because it's situated very high, it will know. Cable standing problems are here, will be low. This is the comparison of a horizontal axis wind turbine and the vertical axis wind turbine. Now we'll go to some of the design parameters and up to here we are just what is wind, what is the wind turbine, what are the types of wind turbine, and we have got the what is the how the wind turbines give the power distribution to the end user. This we have known and this we have studied. See, I am giving you the basic fundamental of the wind energy and capabilities and applications. we are not here because this is a very large area and it has a single whole course. So here only we give a brief description and what is going on in the wind energy systems now. So now from this brief scenario, you can get that how we can work, because all the faculties are in this FDP program, all other faculties. So we have to give the students, or we have to give the students that this is also the area where you can work on, where you can give the projects, or you can make a study project or something else, because this is a very dynamic area of wind. Wind is everywhere and it's free of cost. We have to develop and make mechanisms to get this energy, and which is converted into human use, either in any of the forms like ancient people has done. They are giving a grinding mill, they are getting the pump from this. So I'm giving you an example. In a jungle, Gir forest in Gujarat, they have also made, because in a jungle area, in the summer season, there is a lot of problems related to the water. And if they install any diesel pump or they install any electric line wise pump, they need to make a distribution system for the power to get into the core of the jungle. So what they have done, they have taken the ancient theory of pumping the water from the wind turbine. They have taken the ancient theory of pumping. They have made and digging the well there. They have made a small pond connected to that wind pumps, which gives the water anytime. Right, in night also it pumps. It continuously pumps. So that these animals can, in the time of summer, can get the water easily in the core of the jungle. They cannot have to travel to the village areas or somewhere else to get the water. So this type of research work has been going on, and which help for the community, which help for the society, which help for the human beings. So we can approach by this system to the students so that they can work on these areas. All are working on the software, all are working on the mechanical terms like gears and everything. But this is also a unique area that we have to work on. So wind energy power system, the power has been given by half rho AV cube. Rho is the air density, A is the area of the swift rotor, V cube is the wind speed. Energy from the wind, power is also same thing. We have get the energy from the wind. Energy in the wind increases as the height increases. Now we'll get to the some of the view of our design aspects. Now, till now we have done only the theoretical part. What is the wind? What types is there? Now we'll go to some of the calculative part, that how the wind turbine designs are going on, and what are the aspects of design features of the wind turbine. So wind turbine design aspects gives for the three criteria. One is the aerodynamical performance, the second one is the mechanical strength area, or the third is the economical performance. The wind blade designing have the determination like number of blades, blade shape, blade length, and the tower length. See, this is a twin blade rotor, this is a three blade rotor, and this is a four blade rotor. If we increase the rotor blade, the efficiency will be increased. The efficiency will be already increased. But how its efficiency will be increased? But it also increases the overall cost. So we have to go for the both the features, that it should not increase too much cost, means optimum results should be there. Optimum results should be there. So we have to take the aerodynamically thinner blade. Blade with good structural strength. So thinner blade should also there, but it should have a good structural strength. Look here, this blade has consist of an aerofoil shape. It's not like as a airplane wing. Airplane wing also consists of the similar term. So this consists of an aerofoil shape. This shape we have coated So it becomes a wing structure. So in this, this is the wind direction, and this is the rotation of the blade. So this rotation of the blade, it creates the lift force. It creates the lift force as it flows from the blade. How this aerofoil gives the lift force? I think many of the engineers know that how the airplane flies. Similar way, the wing always gives the lift force, not the fuselage or not the engine. So here also, these aerofoil shapes give the upward force. How they operate? That this is the aerofoil shape. These shape, if a air flows from these aerofoil shape here to root. This is there. Here the attack of angle of the wind will be there. It flows from here to here. See, a wind particle which separates from here, it reach here with this distance of time, and it reach here with a lesser time. So it has to increase its velocity to reach here with that same particle. Like, it's a very simple language I'm explaining you, that if two brothers are going from here, one brother going from the upward and another brother going from the downward, but they have to reach here at the same time. At the same time, so this brother will go in her constant speed, and this brother has to go with a slower speed. So the velocity decreases, then pressure will be increased. The pressure will be increased at the downward side. It gives the lift, or at the upward side. This is only the fundamental for this. The lift will be created at the upward side, and it rotates the blade. It rotates the blade. So the angle of attack, if we have a large angle of attack, then it creates the negative effect. So the negative effect will give the lower lift. So lower lift will be there. Then so optimum angle of attack should be done. That's why they have developed a software, or they have developed a software due to which the implementation of the microprocessors, all this calculative part will be done by a small computers installed in the wind turbine. So they calculate the angle of the wind. They calculate the angle of the wind. According to this, they set the optimum pitch of the blade. See, this is the pitch control. Pitch means the tilting moment of the blade. So they can get the optimum pitch with this algorithm or many of the softwares used, which gives the maximum output. So due to this change in pitch, give every time the output for a maximum aspect. So we have understand the how the we have to design the blade. First, in ancient, the blade was designed with a fixed pitch type. Fixed pitch means the pitch was already fixed, but they have seen that if the fixed pitch is there, but certain times the wind direction changes, so they cannot get the optimum results of the blade and the optimum energy from the wind. So they've decided to change the pitch. So there is not fixed pitch. There is a pitch which changes, pitch of the blade which changes, change with the optimum with the use of microprocessor and with the use of software. So here power equals to efficiency into rho a v cube, as we have heard. So power is directly proportional to the length of the blade, square of the length of the blade. Is overall deflection of the blade. The blade should be like that. It should not get the deflected angle, which can be destroy this hub, or it can be damage the hub, so that the deflection of the blade should be as a design parameter, and it should be calculated before it should be installed or it should be made. So that is your wind turbine design aspects of the blade. And now we told that how, which theory this blade works. Like I have explained you in the general terms that our two brothers are there, they will go and then, but it is as per our academic purpose is there, we have to prove that in a sum of theory. So Blend has given a theory which already everyone knows who are a mechanical background. We are having a Bernoulli's theorem in fluid mechanics or one dimensional analysis. So here I can give you this. There is the kinetic energy, inward kinetic energy and the outward kinetic energy, means input also there is a kinetic energy and here output is the kinetic energy. So Vi is the inlet velocity and V is the exit velocity. So we have got that in a graph that inlet velocity is more, and after this circumference distance or a disk, we are having a disk whose mass flow rate is rho Av. After getting to the disk, it gives a droppage in exit velocity. So these differences used by this plate. So average velocity will be Vi plus V by 2. And we heard that we have seen this figure in the Bernoulli's theorem. This is the section 1 and this is section 2. We have a conical tube type of structure. We assume that this is a tube type of structure with all the assumptions taken. So m dot equals to rho A V. V is the total average velocity. Now power will be your mv square. So here we'll substitute this here. So V equals to inlet by 3. Power max will be 8 by 127 rho A V cube. So we note that the power is directly proportional to the velocity cube. Because area and density is always a constant. So maximum efficiency of the three-axis wind turbine, we'll get it as 59.26%. So it's good to get the efficiency of the wind turbine as 60%. After all, this is the assumption, after taking this assumptions, this is only the theoretical efficiency. But after all the practical oriented drag and friction, if we implement that thing, we'll get around 40 to 42% of the efficiency in the wind turbine. So this law has been given by the Blend's limit law, which gives the efficiency as 59.26%, and all the horizontal axis wind turbines operates in this Blend's limit. So now we have discussed the blade design parameters, and we have already discussed the efficiency, how the efficiency comes, which gives around 59.2%. So this gives you, first we have gone for the, I will take a review for from where we started. We started from the wind, then we gone from the history of the wind turbine. From the wind, what we'll get? We get the windmill. We get the wind turbine, how the windmill operated in the ancient times, and now wind, how the wind turbines operated. What are the types of wind turbines, like horizontal axis, vertical axis wind turbines. And these wind turbines, what are the parameters of designing these wind turbines? Then how the wind energy or this energy is converted into electrical energy, and how the distribution system works of these winds to the house. Whole thing or to the industrial thing, means how the energy has been distributed from wind farm to the end user. So we have seen that how it will work and how it is stored also. We have seen that how it is stored into the battery. So, and next parameters, we have seen that the how the blades are important parameter for designing. And we have also seen that how the different law is incorporated for the three-axis wind turbine, like Blend's limit law, which comes from the Bernoulli's one-dimensional analysis. So this gives you a picture that this is the things which already going on and it happens. So we have to create and think about that what the new should be done to these existing features. What are the research areas which will take, like blade designing is also a fundamental research area where everyone is working on. Everyone is working on the blade designing. Everyone is working on the low scale wind turbines. Many projects are going on that, like that, we can have a solar panel installed in the terrace. Like we can have a small wind turbine installed at the different household equipment or different locations. The cost will be also a factor, but here the maintenance cost, if the output will be more, then the cost will be managed. So we have to turn on this. Now I'll go that what are the size, shape of the wind turbine and where India stands on the wind turbine. So typical turbine size, so there is a 1.3 to 1.8 megawatt rated capacity. Rotor diameter is of 60 to 180 meter. But nowadays there are 120 meters rotor size, length, single length. Turbine footprint of 10 meter to 10 meter. Lowest ground clearance is at least at 100 foot. Okay, the different turbine blade length. It comes from 50 meter to 120 meter rotor diameter. Rotor diameter means 60 meter blade length. Here length of 60 meter means the Boeing 747 length is already lower as compared to this wind turbine blade. Why we are talking of all this? Because we have to save the energy. We have to save the environment. As energy used by the power plant has account for 67% of the air emissions of SO2, the primary cause of acid rain, SO2 causes acidification of lakes, damage to the forest and other habitats. And it gives the 25% of the nitric oxide, 33% of the mercury, percent is the bioaccumulative toxin, which increases in concentration and moves up to a food chain. For example, fish to birds, causing a serious damage and nerve disorders. These, to save from all these disasters, because of the disasters, already we are see that all world is having a problem. Like today we are going on online FDP due to COVID-19. All world is suffering from this small virus, which comes from a one person. I think so, one person or some whatever news are there. So this comes from a one person. Now it covers to the 50 lakh people. So it, see what the problem arises. But this is also a serious problem which we are not seeing, which we are not assumption that after 50 years or 60 years, if this same emission goes on, what could happen? See what means no one exists that this happens, then what we'll do? If all the air at outside or in our home will be polluted or will be of some of the gases or some of the wrong gases or some of the effect gases, then we could not imagine that what the world will lose. So in order to save the environment, everyone is looking after. So everyone is looking after all the aspects of renewable energy. So that's why I congratulate this Department of Cummins College, so that they have taken an initiative of great initiative towards saving our environment. So wind energy benefits. What are the wind energy benefits? No air emissions, no fuel to mine to transport or store, no cooling water, no water pollution, no waste. These are the major benefits we'll get from the wind energy. Now the wind energy installation in India, look, up to 2002, there are only 16666 install capacity was installed in the India, means megawatt capacity. Now we are having 27,441 megawatt capacity installed, already installed up to 2016-17 in India. So we are growing day by day since last 20 years. We have gone through a huge development of more than 100%. So from 2000 megawatt capacity to 27,000 megawatt capacity, it's a huge change which the India has done. And as now this government has already established a Ministry of Renewable Sources, so they are working on it. And many projects related to the faculties also they are giving. So there is also a site of Ministry of renewable energy, you have to go to the website. There are the project formats are there. If you want any of the project to be submitted, go through it, work on it, and submit the project for a greater cost to the human being. Indian renewable energy scenario is we are giving a 65% of the wind turbine. Here also a point some percent is there from waste to energy. Solar energy is 13%. It increases as this ratio is of 2016-17. By 3 years, many of the solar plants have been established, like government of Gujarat, government of Chhattisgarh, Maharashtra. They have also been used in developing the solar plant, solar farm. Before that, we are not having the solar farm. The wind farms we are already having, but the solar farm we are not having. Biomass power and small hydropower. State-wise wind production in India, Tamil Nadu is the highest producing state of the wind energy, next is the Gujarat and Maharashtra, Karnataka, Rajasthan. See, these states are there. Apart from these states, many research is going on that we can install a small wind turbine in a capacity where we cannot use the solar or we cannot use the to get the thermal power energy from there. This is a layout of the energy distribution in India. The red gives the where the wind energy is situated, generally located. Where the wind energy is located. The red gives the more wind turbines and the green gives the lesser than that. So we have seen that in MP also some areas are there where we are having wind turbines. Here also we are having in Andhra Pradesh some areas. But major wind turbine areas are this one. Maharashtra also we are having the wind turbine. Wind energy utilization in India. This is a demographic said that how the wind energy is utilized in India. Already I have told that Tamil Nadu having 19.4 megawatt wind power plant. Next one is Gujarat, third one is the Maharashtra, the same utilization status of wind energy. So we are from the Ministry of Renewable Energy, we have got the target of 60 gigawatt by 2022. So if someone goes for the wind energy, many companies have come into the existence of generating wind power. Now, wind power already with the solar power we are getting into the existence, as wind power is somewhat costly at the initial stage, but this a wind turbine which is installed gives 25 to 30 years currently it gives the energy without any further installation cost. Only the maintenance cost will be beared. So if a wind turbine is installed, it is installed for more than 25 years, so we'll get the energy from a single wind turbine to 25 years. So global wind energy production, but still after this mission also we are not in a top 10 or top 20 countries in the world for the global wind energy production. See, this is the global wind energy production index. We are not a single 1% of the we are producing the energy in the global scenario. Like Denmark is there, which gives the highest as a 15.6% of the energy of the world is producing by Denmark. So we have to work on that. Our ministry has to work on that to get the wind energy more and more. And we have to stop the thermal power plants. As the change, it suffers something extra, but we have to save our fossil fuel for the future. And we have seen two types of wind energy. Now the recent trend is there. We have always seen that in a sea, always the wind breeze throughout the wind flows in the sea coastal areas or in the sea area. Throughout the wind blows from day and night. So why cannot we collect or why cannot we install the wind turbines in the sea? So the future of this wind turbines will get in this video. You can see that what is going on actually in the world. Sea is only meant for the sea, for the ships to sail, but now sea is meant for the developing or for getting the energy from it. So there is the world's first floating wind turbine, which is installed in the Norwegian and you can look the huge research and development of Norway. So Scotland has developed wind farms on the sea. It is connected with a buoy. Buoy is connected with a huge ropes, and which is stick into the bottom of the sea like this. So this is the future is going on. Means we are having a wind. So this wind turbine will operate day and night 24 hours as all the mechanism has been developed. As the operation, I told already that the situational and operational installation cost is more, but for 25 years this turbine will work and give the constant energy, and it also saves the world from the emission of the gases which create destruction for the human being. So this ends my lecture today, and the conclusion is that after getting the wind energy or after getting wind energy installed, we will have an insurance against the conventional fossil based price risk, and we'll get the no greenhouse or gas emission, no sulfur dioxide, nitro dioxide or mercury emission. So this is our the conclusion. So let's go and take the our research areas as the non-renewable energy sources and the wind turbine and work out on that, make the student projects on that, let them study. As a mechanical engineer, there are lots of prospects in this field, in the field of wind turbine. So thank you very much. If any questions,